The non-performing assets of public sector company have crossed Rs. 7.77 trillion on 31st December 2017 and has been rising steadily for the past 8 years. Now, what is a non-performing asset and how does it affect Indian economy? You will get to know it by the end of this video. Hi, my name is Chirag Patel, student of Indian Institute of Management Ritchie, and today I am going to explain the NPA problems faced by the banks in India and its impact on Indian economy. Now, what is NPA? The assets of a bank which don't bring any return are called non-performing assets or bad loans. Bank's assets are the loans and advances given to the customer. And if customer don't pay either interest or part of principal or both, the loan turns into a bad loan. According to RBI, term loans on which interest or installment of principal remain overdue for a period of more than 90 days, it is called a non-performing asset. What are the reasons for the rise in NPA in recent years? Between early 2000s and 2008, Indian economy were in a boom phase. During this period, banks, especially public sector banks, lent extensively to corporates. However, the profits of most of the corporate dwindled due to slowdown in global and domestic economy. This has adversely affected their ability to pay back loans and in most cases, important reason behind increase in NPA of public sector banks. The second main reason of rising NPA was the relaxed lending norms, especially for the corporate home loans, when their financial status and credit rating was not properly analyzed. Also, to face competitions, banks were usually selling unsecured loans. The third main reason is the lack of bankruptcy code in India and a sluggish legal system which make it difficult for the banks to recover their loans from both corporates and the non-corporates. What is the impact of non-performing assets on Indian economy? The problem of NPAs in the Indian banking system is one of the foremost and the most formidable problems that has impacted the entire banking system. Depositors do not get rightful returns and many times may lose unsecured deposits. Banks may begin charging higher interest on some products to compensate non-performing loan losses. Bank shareholders have been adversely affected. In the last 2 months, share prices of Punjab National Bank have fell from about Rs. 180 per share to Rs. 100 per share. Bad loans imply that the funds are being redirected from good projects to the bad ones. Hence, the economy suffers due to loss of good projects and the failure of bad investment. When a bank do not get loan repayment or interest payments, it may lead to liquidity problems. How to tackle these NPAs? The banks need to assess the viability case by case. The viable accounts need to be given more finance for turnaround and the unviable accounts should be either given to asset reconstruction companies or permit the banks to take over the units. A strong bankruptcy code is required. It makes it easier for banks to recover loans from the unviable enterprises. The government should establish asset reconstruction company. An asset reconstruction company acquires bad loans from banks and financial institutions and works to recover them from a variety of measures. The banks can then focus on the core activity of lending. Banks should improve credit risk management. This includes credit appraisal, credit monitoring, and efficient system of fixing accountability. It also helps in analyzing trends in group leverage to which the borrowing firm belongs to. Banks should start seeing the promoter's contribution is funded through equity and not debt. Banks should conduct necessary sensitivity analysis and contingency planning while appraising the projects, and it should build adequate safeguards against such external forces. Until now, lower-rank officials were considered accountable even though loaning decisions were taken at a higher level. The sanctioned officials should also take the burden of responsibility. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching this video.